careful. I had to move the cursor away from the stop sign. Because with the touchpad, when I touch a little bit too much energy, then stop, and I have to start again. But in the beginning is no problem. It's worse when the video is nearly finished and then it stops. So, didn't go out yet because every second day I go to the restaurant to treat the sparrow cats, and this I will do after 4 p.m. when the afternoon prayers. Afternoon pray. Then I go there because then the customers already left. So not to do this thing in front of the customers because they would not like it, even though it's a open restaurant also, very simple, you know, with plastic chairs and so on. They would not like it to see, and some even know what this sparrow is, you know. They don't want to come to eat anymore, you know what I mean? Because it is highly infectious, but not for me, you know. A little bit I have to be careful when I have open cut. Like here I got one from the cat, you know, the feet of the cat. I want to get off me, fighting a little bit. Yeah. So today, good topic. Let's go into it. It is probably from 2019. If I can get it up now, the notepad. Ah, it's up. You can see also with the light a little bit more. On Facebook, when I was still connected with Arthur Christian Love for Life. You can check it out on Facebook and on YouTube. And so Arthur had something about whatever. You know, he's writing articles and then you can read it. People complain, it's so long, you know. You click on more and then you see, oh, all long. And he seemed to mostly type it himself, you know, because hardly I find repetition also. So he's just on the computer typing, you know. Yeah, it's his mission. So anyway, then I think maybe somebody commented and went into the Bible thing. And then about this, you know, Genesis, probably, you know, the beginning, Genesis 1. Genesis 1, you know, Genesis, the genes of Isis. Isis stands for the moon, for the illusion. The moon Isis us, frozen, 32 degrees Fahrenheit, you have to get to 33, the 33rd grade of Freemasonry. You need to get this level of knowledge, then you are no more frozen. Yeah. Okay. So then I wrote it down first in the notepad and then I copied this in and I got a heart from Arthur for this. Very good. And this is also when he realized other people commented to other comments also, whatever, that I'm stupid or whatever. And Arthur said, no, he has this spot on. Arthur realized, even in his strange writing style, but this case is, I think, quite okay, how I'm writing. It's readable. So don't focus on things that you think is mistake. It's actually not mistake when I put it like this. You accept it with the brand names as well, yeah. So in the mainstream media, they also use certain codes and whatever. So, yeah. And then he said this, you know, no. This guy is not stupid, you know. He knows something. He learned something from Arthur, you know. Yeah. And others, I realized, you know, my God, they are so long time with Arthur. Didn't they read what he's writing? I think they read, but they didn't comprehend. Carter is writing idiot friendly. It's the best writing style you can find. You only need to be able, you know, to be able to read English, you know what I mean? But it's not enough. You really need more. Everybody, I think, imagines this is the problem with words, something else. That's why you will never understand what I or what Arthur are saying. What I'm thinking, you cannot be on this level. And it doesn't mean higher or lower. You will be just not seeing the things that I see, because we imagine through the words only. Imagination is fantasy, and you have another fantasy. Because every man, every life form is unique and original. So your senses will be slightly different. And then you see things different. This is why we have the differences also. That you think, my God, why can't they see these things or comprehend? Especially when you think you present the truth, which certainly is not the truth, but, you know, going into this direction, then they cannot see it, you know. But there's also explanation for this. So I wrote my comment. Now, let's go deeper into the biblical bullshit, because Arthur calls it the Bible bullshit. Yeah, biblical. Biblio, bibliothek in German, is the library. That means, you know, Bible is the book. It is the book. The one book. The one eye book, you can say. But in another video on YouTube, you will find it for as long as YouTube is available. I made a video about, you know, all books are 666 fantasy, and the internet too, of course. Even more, because in the internet you have all books united in a library. Library. The brewery of all lies. And it really is. But the fantasy, again, as I see it, can be very close to the reality. And what I'm presenting here is fantasy. It's not reality. It's very close to reality. This is where the trap is, and that's why Arthur said the biggest liar is the one closest to the truth. So if I'm one of the closest to the truth, and it looks like this, with what I'm saying, revealing about the system, as Jabba, as Arthur, and Huron last, I would say also, and also others that are not known to me, or, you know, something like this. You cannot know all the people. I also don't have the time to watch this, or, you know what I mean. I have to be very selective, especially when I'm now presenting things. Then you have even less time, and the computer is so slow. I cannot really. I'm happy when I can make the video and upload this, you know. Yeah. So, and he calls it by bullshit. But it is, in the end, it is nonsense bullshit. You know, you don't need this shit. But only when you have returned to the nature, then you can throw it away. But until then, also Arthur said that the Bible is the blueprint of the system. There's a system inside, the whole agenda, and not only one time in the Old Testament as well as in the New Testament. It is partially also hidden there, but you have also compressed, combined in the John's Revelation, but we don't know how to read it until it happens. Yeah, I also only knew, okay, this Corona thing is the white horse, because the word Corona you will find in connection with the white horse. It's John's Revelation 6.3. Normally I don't remember numbers, but this one I do remember. Ray member. You are the member of Ray. You're part of this. Yeah. So it is then not really bullshit, but for someone or somebody who is already on the way, go back to nature, you know, create a food forest in the idea, in the head. This is what you need. It doesn't matter how successful you are. Then then it is already bullshit. And he doesn't need to study this anymore. He puts this aside, you know. But the knowledge that he has is from many books, I think, you know. And that's why it is not reality, you know. It is still fantasy, but when he is not saying the reality is like this, but he says the fantasy is like this, the world is like this, then he can, you know, bring it forward. And this is then just revealing the lie. But when you say, oh, I'm speaking the truth, you know, and you have to believe what I'm saying, and you must follow me. Follow me, follow me, follow me, or die, you know. Yeah, then there's something wrong already. Especially when you know more, then you see already, oh, you know, David Icke and so on. There's something. It's entertaining, but there's something missing. There's a missing part. This is probably for a reason, or this guy is just like this. It's just his limit, you know what I mean? And you have to come further than your teacher, better than your mentor, you know? So I cannot say that I'm better than Arthur. In certain ways I can point out things, but he's still on a great level. So he's on in his own league without competition, actually, you can say, yeah. There's not really competition in this. And so I also have to recognize that I copy certain things also from him, and when I realize this, then I also mention from whom it is. Yeah, probably I have to mention many names throughout the whole presentation, you know, but that's okay. So it starts, it's actually on the left side, if this is all in line. I'm not sure when I copy this in YouTube it would be down the line. On the left hand side is usually this, what is from the Bible, and then my explanation to this. Yeah, and that's what they don't want you, that you explain the Bible, you know. You have to just read it and then imagine this, and as a believer you imagine all kind of fantasy which is very far away from reality, I can tell you. But actually these words, if you understand this right, you will come very close to the reality. To what is this all, you know? Bullshit. It is shit. You know? The whole agenda. Yeah. It says. It's probably the first word. I would have to take the Bible, the book, and to check, but I think it is the beginning. Genesis 1. In the beginning was the word. I make it already in brackets because it's the past. Yeah, in the beginning you're already referring to the past. I think I give first my own thinking about this, and then I will also read out what I found in 2019. Maybe there's still some difference. You see, in the beginning, begin, you know, be is also life, alive, to be. Yeah, in the beginning means time. And when there is a beginning, there must be an end. And this is what you find then also in the end of the Bible, you know, there is an end to this. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello. Wait a second, I have to pause, yes? Wait a second.
Because it looks like it were bad.
Yeah, so this was another helping woman. She just brought me the food. Can I show this? There's no sauce inside. A carrot on the rice and vegetable down there. And this is probably not meat, this is tofu. It looks like meat. He just brought me this from the food donation, and we had a chat together. I don't know, maybe more than this time here. Ah, now I cannot open this, so I will have to stop it again, because I need to open the coffee before the water is getting cold. So, resumed. Resumed. Always when you see the ray, in Latin it is pronounced ray. The English would usually pronounce it re. But everything, re, ra, re, ro, ru, is Amon Ra. And the word ru in Thai, Pali Sanskrit, means knowledge, or also knowing. Okay, so let's continue this. It says, in the beginning was the word. Okay, so there is the beginning, but also the past. And that's very strange, no? But I capitalized the word, and this is, the capitalization is for a reason, because this is, I think even they did this in the Bible, even capitalized. And that is actually Doc's Latin, and it means every single letter you have to see. WORD. Backward it would read draw, draw or drow, like drowning. Yeah, so you are drowning in the sea, you are fading away with the words. It really is like this. In the beginning was the word. So it was there already in the beginning. Because it is was. Yeah. That's what I see, the deeper thing. You would say it started with the word. That's also okay. But it says very clearly, in the beginning, now it's the beginning, there was the word already. Yeah. So I write after this, it, the word, already existed. It was there already. But it is true that when the word appeared, Om Hindustan, then this was the beginning. And I think it was about 6,000 years ago. I would not go further, because the further you go with the numbers, this is more, you know, millions of years ago and so on. This is all bullshit. 6,000 years, you can imagine better. In the beginning. Not at the beginning. In the beginning. So there is a beginning, but it's in the beginning. That means even the beginning is a time frame. Yeah? Measured. Because if you have the time from, let's say, 1 to 10 hours, you have also the ruler, 1 to 10. Yeah? So this is what I saw. In the beginning, not at the beginning. So it is in the beginning, but also there was already the word. So that means from alpha to omega, that is actually Greek writing. You see the alpha and the omega is written like this also, or from A to Z. Because alpha is the beginning, and the omega, the Z, is the end. Omega is the end, and the O shows also the 1000 years cycle. The word forms the artificial world. You can see that the word with an L is the world. They just put an L inside because the words form the artificial means not real, world. Everything that is not real does not exist, it is not alive. and the L, when they put an L inside, you should also think what the L means. When you just pronounce it, you have L, E-L, or A-L, which is El Satan, or referring to God, Elohim. Yeah, the many gods, actually. And L, the letter L, also symbolizes the high seat of the Pope, because he is the highest king, so to speak. Yeah? It's not just the religious leader, because the kings are also submitted to the religion, if you check it out. Yeah. So, the word forms the artificial world. The great lie is that they claim that a word can exist. They write it somehow, or, you know, the living Bible or something. That means the living book. There is no living book. It's all dead. So they make the claim. In the word claim, you see the lie, L-A-I. When you pronounce it straight, you pronounce lie. Yeah, the word does not exist, but you give energy to the words, word constructs, the thoughts, your life energy. And as Bruno said also, you need a lot of energy for thinking. Probably more energy than for moving your body. And it's probably spiritual energy. So you give all your life force energy into this spiritual thing. You can also say spiritual thing, into the thoughts, which is all black magic. That's why you become the devil automatically. That's why you should realize, find out who you are, means you will find out that you are the devil, and find out who you should be, or, you know, who you have been in the past, 6,000 years ago, before the fall of Adam and Eve, or, as Sean says, Adam and Steve, nowadays, no? Yeah, then you would come to something that you would refer to God. I say living creator, because God is already the fantasy world, you know what I mean? Living creator is the one closest to the truth. Yeah, so they make claims, but existence means to be, yeah, William Shakespeare, to be alive, also alive, you are a life form, undefined, formless, shapeless. Does a word have life? Some people would say yes. Because they're already so lost in the fantasy, you know? The answer is no. There is the deception, and therefore, misunderstanding of the words. There is the deception. The deception is in believing that the word is alive. And thereof, misunderstanding of the words. With its simplified or deeper meanings of pure Masonic fantasy derived from a crazy disgraced Namboodiri fucktard. Like this. So, yeah, deception of the words. So the Namboodiri is actually somebody who deceived the other people in his area in Kerala. This is how it started. You know, you have the deeper meanings of the words, or, you know, the other meanings of the words. There's different methods that you can learn with Kiran Last to find out what is hidden in the words. Yeah, and this is Masonic fantasy that is building the wall, you know. The wall of fantasy. You know Pink Floyd, The Wall also. This is actually the wall. And this has started with Namboodiri. So far I can see. Yeah? And it's also not to blame anybody, because these people are still here. They are just lost. That's it. Like most of the people, you know? Like the woman I talked here also, there's no chance to turn around. She says, I know you are true, but she has to obey the rules. How can you call this, you know? It's a soldier, a soldier from the beginning. They don't know anything else, especially in Asia, you know? That's why they have to work hard on the Western people, because there is the most resistance, really. But the knowledge is not enough to do this in the correct way. Most of the people will do this wrong on the streets. The streets belong to the system, and so they will bring in the forces. That's for sure. So, next line. It says in the Bible, the Word was with God. Mm-hmm. The Word, again, was. It's always of the past, because thoughts are of the past as well. So the moment somebody writes this, somebody has written this, yeah, was with God. So that means in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. That means there is a Word, but it is with God. With a God. And so you can see it anyway. The words are with me. Yeah, I'm speaking the words. Okay. But actually, it's not part of life. That means the living creator, that is the man, completely lost it. Step by step, but he lost it. You know, that's why the word God instead of living creator. They could call it living creator. But they use this fantasy term God, and probably they don't really define it, but you know, they put fantasy pictures into your head. Okay, I must look that I'm in the right line also. I was writing then that God must be this grand architect that Arthur was referring to. Grand architect, no? The Red Indians even call it grand architect. But this is all the architect of the world, not of the earth. You know, from the beginning. Grand, grande, great. Great architect. Yeah? You see the arc inside, the ARC or ARK, you can also make it. This is the arc. Arctis, Antarctis. Yeah? You have the one gate, arc means gate, and you have the other gate, anti-Arctis. Yeah? So the one that is on the opposite side. And that must be the grand architect then, because the creator of the living doesn't need any words for it. So when the earth was created, I can tell you, this was through a conscious dream. You can call it maybe like this. Yeah, this is very hard to describe, because we are so far away of this and words cannot really describe it, but I think this is kind of close to it. And there was no words or something. It's just probably also the imagination pictures. I think animals have this also, of what you're dreaming for, you know. And this become then reality, because when you are the living creator, the creator of all life and the life forms, probably the sun, the day sun, then you can do these things and you don't need any words. Words are absolutely limited. You can see already how it is misunderstood, yeah? I have to put some more water on this. the living creator would use or is using just senses, the senses, yeah? Not words. So this is another creator, or it is. Now I think I know when, you know, the living creator is the man, then of course the Namboodiri is also man, but already lost because he calls himself Namboodiri or is called like this. And then, you know, with the words, the sounds of the words, is something magic because, you know, man did sounds like the animals, but these sounds, you know, with vowels and consonants, this is then already going in another direction, and then other men will listen to this, getting hypnotized. You know that this is about hypnosis as well, yeah? So, yeah, and the word was God, it says. It says actually further in the Bible, no? And the word was God. And I think also they put the word, I think I copied this really in, and the word God with a capitalized letter. And you can do this somehow, but it's also questionable because in real grammar you would not capitalize the word, at least. But because the word was God, and I think God can be capitalized in the grammar rules, because it is a title. In this case, when the word was God, then is the word also a title, yeah? And again, was. Okay, because they are talking about the past. So then suddenly is not only the word is with God, the word is then God. That means the word actually replaced the man, the creator. The word becomes God. But that's just a mental construct. Yeah? So that means the mental construct is kind of creation also, yeah? The creation, the creation become the creator. But this creation is not real, does not exist, is not alive. So the dead becomes the creator and can only create dead things. This is the problem here. That's why you see this happening. So the word became superior. Yeah? Superior. You have this also. Super means S, up, or is ray. Then you have the re, and the or is the row. You have snake or Satan, up. Ra ra ra. This is what superior means. And that's what it is. Actually, the real God means life and truth, which is identical. Life and truth is identical, yeah? Ah, the real God. But there's also the word God real with R-E-E-L, which is also the ray ray, ra ra. And the word real is also Amun Ra, because Ray is, you know, Ra, and El, you know, means God, sun god, means, real means sun god, the word, you know? But what is, you know, imagined by the word real, for most of the people lost in fantasy, it is, everything is real, the fantasy is real, you only need to say, it's like real, you know, it's like real, it's not real. You know, it's only like real. And that's why I always have to emphasize, and you need to get this in your head, real means existent, alive, and nothing else. So it must be alive. It must have senses to sense you. Not only you sense it. No? So, third line, every line I should have a zip. So, next line we have to look, where is this? Here, this one. Because it's all written together so that I don't forget one line, you know? Then suddenly it says, he existed in the beginning with God. So there's this kind of repetition where you think, what are they talking about, you know? Suddenly it's the he coming up. Who? First you think the God. He existed in the beginning with God. He existed with God. And then you look back, they mean the word. Because, and the word was God. The word becomes he. I did not know that word is he. I would call it, because I also wrote it, it already existed, right? Now it's why it's called he. Because also in German, the word, which is Wort, is just with the T instead of the D. So it is from German. The word is from German. And thus the world as well, Welt. Then you call it, because it is in German das Wort. That means it is, you know, it. It is not female, feminine or masculine. Then they make it masculine. Probably because the writers, the occultists, are probably all masculine. You know? So they make it he. This is, it tells you in the beginning already why the word he is coming, referring to God. But they tell you, not the God that you imagine is the God, it is the he, which in Thai means the cunt. Really, it's no joking, yeah? When I was teaching and I was writing on the board, he, and then, you know, the sentence, the students were laughing, because I pronounce it exactly as a cunt. He, this is the pronunciation in Thai for the cunt. If you say another tone, then it has another meaning, you know? So, and it matches. But it's not just the Namboodiri grand architect of all this nonsense. It is the word is the cunt. Like the cunt tribe. To try a cunt. Country. Yeah? So that's the he. The he is the word. The word is God. And you can see it now. How the influence of the words. Maybe my influence, but mainly, you know, through the media and other people that come to you and want to tell you what you have to do. Like she said to me, come, I bring you for the vaccine. And she also said to me that, I said, there's no one left anymore. She said, yes, I also don't know anybody who's not vaccinated. They're all vaccinated here in the city. It's only you, she said. Within a short time, just a couple of months, 5 months ago or something, before August, it was 5%. They were very reluctant. And I was so proud, you know, I thought, good. You know, the people here are just lazy, you know, and I think the 5% is maybe mainly the Chinese population, you know. But the Malay didn't want this. You know, they are all in. They don't know how else to survive. She said this also. You know, you are here inside, and we support you here inside with the food, but we have to be outside and we have to continue our business and so on. I did not say anything anymore to this, you know. Because you cannot say to these people, you know, maybe you should not continue the business as usual. Maybe you should go and create your food garden to take care of yourself. And in the beginning, you join your community and together. But when the community is all thinking like this, then you join the wrong way, you know. But again, she also said, oh, it was like, she cannot say anything against it. She said, yeah, what you say is true, but when she say, I know. So actually they know and decide to die. You know, now have Omicron, she said. Yeah, I say, you get another 3 shots. You are literally getting shot. You don't understand this. But I said also, now it's too late. You have already decided. And you know, with the mask and the wielder's mask, you know, the shield. And on the shield was already all the wet, you know, the wet film from her breath. And I told her also that on our tube I watched a video about the you know, CO2 measurement for the climate change people, so they have also good benefit, because the woman tested inside the mask and then the alarm went off for danger. So that even the technology shows you that this is dangerous when you wear a mask. Unbelievable. So I'm probably the only one left here. And you can imagine what happens, huh? When you're only one left. And this will apply to you as well, but in the West still there will be more people. It will be more likely next year that you will find I'm just one left, if you make it. Very likely you will also be vaccinated without physical force yet. When there's physical force, this is something else. Then, you see, there are people they cannot resist, like my mother, you know, when they're old or something, what can they do, you know? Or disabled people, or maybe also women, they can also not really, some women would like to fight, but, you know, resistance is assistance as well. So you better prepare yourself for this, and, you know, have your tactic. When you're ready to give up your physical life to gain the real life, the eternal life, so to speak, then you do this your tactical way so that they can only put the shit into your dead ass. Or I also think that if you are being forced and you're being overcome, because they will come very in a very smart way so that they can catch you and put you in your body while you are still alive and continue to live, or maybe die of this vaccine shot as well, whatever, then it was not you, you know, you were not doing this. This is the most important thing. You did not give in. As Pink Floyd also singing, you know, don't give in without a fight. But it must be not a useless fight, you know, like I'm fighting and struggling and then I cannot fight anymore, I'm finished, you know, like this. You must really have this imagination what will happen. Even they come with, you know, Waco style and with helicopters and so on, whatever. And then, you know, against these forces you cannot win, but you can make them do something that could be called a mistake, you know. Because it's not that you go and say, okay, I actually do suicide this way. Because when I hold the gun, then one of them will shoot for sure, you know. Don't shoot until they shoot or they come closer, you know. Because they, you know, the tactic, they also come around and suddenly they are behind you in from inside the house already, you know, broke through the window. Then you know when this is the case, you run towards the others and shoot, maybe in the legs or something. But it's better not to shoot them, you know. Let them do this. Because they came to you. Remember this. They came to you. They have nothing to do with you. This is the gangster. Nothing else. Gangster in uniform. And actually they hire also gangster, you know. And I heard also in a video of Tim Larkin, he's doing some interviews. It looks like in the US also, you know, people being killed, they just release them out of custody. So that means now the crime is really coming up. The criminals, those who with the malevolent intent, is now their time. And they will do, and they will be very organized. They will use this tool because then you need to fight. You know what I mean? And then you have this kind of civil war. Then they can come in with their NATO forces from above and whatever, you know. Then they have another Hunger Games style. And you cannot prevent this. It's just happening, you know. Anyway, for this you have to be prepared. But I wanted to continue here this. The word was with God. Is it here in the right line? No, it's already next. He existed in the beginning with God. And this is the claim of the existence, what I wrote before. He, the word, existed. The word does not exist. Existence means alive. This is a big deception here in this. So they deceive, or they have deceived themselves into this problem by using this word. Or maybe it's a wrong translation as well. So, yeah, in the beginning, It was there. It was. Is another replacement for existed. Yeah? But existed is explicitly for alive. Because was is from to be, you know? So that means, also it means something about alive, that actually it means the word was not. You know this? The word was not, because the word is not alive. Again, if you can realize this, still, that the word is not alive. ABC 123 is not alive. It has no life. It cannot sense you. It cannot see you, whatever. Then there was no word at all. Even you hear this now. Yeah? It all does not exist. It is the nothing. The darkness. Black magic. This is what it is. And that's why there is already the bullshit, as I see it. Deeper meaning, but it is still the bullshit. What I'm revealing here is only the bullshit of what happened. So the word, then my explanation. So the word is he or him, not it. You change it from it. It would be correct. And also Eyes Wide Open calls it it. Do you know what it really is? This is where you see it. Yeah. You can also, you know, it, you can call it the Satan or something. But this is all the Satanism about the word. The world actually is the Satan, because the words are in your head. The Satan, the devil is in your head. Development. Devil-op-ment. The devil in your mind. Okay, so you have to then know, okay, when they say he or him will come also in the next line, it means the word. And you will forget this if you continue to read, you know what I mean? You will not think that God means the word, the he and the him means the word. And they don't say it anymore. It would be correct to say it. Yeah? For those lost in fantasy, thoughts are existent. This is the problem. Lost in fantasy. When you think that your thought does exist, you're already lost. You're not of reality. All the thoughts, everything you have, it's spinning around in your head. It's very, very strong, you know, the black magic. You even get a headache from this. You cannot even sleep. It all does not exist. It is the nothing. You cannot sleep because of the nothing, because it's a black hole. That's why you cannot sleep. Even though in the darkness you can sleep actually very well, but this black hole is frightening. You are falling. That's why. Of course, the word was with the grand architect, Mason, of Nimrod, Babylon. Yeah? The word was with God. Remember this? So, the God is the GA, the grand architect, Mason, of the masonry. Because the GA you find in the logo. You find the G, and the compass and the square is the A. Because the A you can make like this inside. This is also a version of an A. Yeah, you can make it like this. Maybe, I think there are also, you know, symbols from certain whatever companies that have this logo in. And just to show I'm also one of them, you know. Yeah. And then Nimrod Babylon. In this connection. Babylon, also baby long. You're forever the baby, crying, you know, and yeah, it's already, you know, further development out of Hindustan, Persia, there's already the connection to Babylon, and then Nimrod, the rod, like an iron rod where you have to hold on, you know, the Mormons use this word. Nim would actually meaning to take in German, but with double M. So, then, next line. God created everything through him, the word. There's a him, you know? Which is very, very deceiving, you know? That's why the people think of a man with long beard and so on. Which is the Namboodiri, you compare it, you will see. It is the occultist. God, the Word actually, created everything through him, the Word. So the Word creates through the Word, because the Word, the first sound, create more. From you change it around, you make it first, they have it in Thai also, Amon as well, then Im in German, in the, M, the emphasis or something, you know, the prefix, also in German, the UM, and so on, and then you change it around, you have more and more words, yeah. So the word creates more and more words as you think to create more and give meaning to this, you know. And you say this is this is im, this is you start like this in that language, you know what I mean, and you develop it more and more. This is how it goes, and he's fantastic, and everybody surrounds him, you know what I mean, yeah, until they realize what kind of bullshit this is, and that the people start to fight with each other, you know, over the words and misunderstandings. Yeah. Remember, the God now means the Word. They said it above, you know. You can read it in the Bible again if you think this is wrong copy or something. It really says like this. That means the grand architect created the world filled with words. Yeah. But in his fantasy, he believes the lie is in the belief. Yesterday Bohm and Krishnamurti talking, and then I think Bohm, I think he said, you know, belief and so on, you know, in the word belief is the word love, because the leaf is the love. Yeah, you can see somehow the connection also, that means that he knows about the word creation, William Shakespeare style, Francis Bacon, he must know about it, he's initiated, but I would not see love in this. I would see the lie in this. You can see the lie, the way I wrote it also, yeah? The lie is inside, and he didn't mention this, 75. Yeah? So, in that time, they were way back, really. Belief is love, yeah? And love is illusion. I put this up in the video there. Love and pedophilia. So, fuck, you know? He believes to have created also the earth. Big liar. But actually not big liar. Because this Namboodiri, before the 6,000 years, before he fell with the word Om, he was one of the creator. His ancestors. Because his ancestors, your ancestors, is you. It's always you. It's always the living creator. That continues, you know? Different bodies, and maybe even just had one body for forever until the fall. So then he started to die, because physically also, because he was cursing himself with the black magic of the sounds, the unnatural sounds, and so on, more and more. And so it is at that time. It's not correct what I was writing, that's why I have to say this. He was inner believing he is the creator of Earth. And he still knew it, he still remembered this. It's only now we have forgotten this. But those who are leading, like the Pope, they know. They know. Yeah? That's why they can play God. Not only because they have knowledge, they also know who is the living creator that turned into a devil. Yeah? Destroying this whole creation. So, but still you have to see the difference, because in the beginning, it's not the beginning, the creation of the earth. Even they explain this also, they have to put this in, because otherwise it would be an empty space. So they have to create something that you find yourself in here. It is true that the ancestors before created the earth, but not this guy. He created only the word, and out of the words, the world. So So what is coming after, you know, the creation of Earth in 7 days or 6 days? Bullshit, no? The 6th day, the man was created then, no? The 666 man. Yeah. So, next one, more than 1 hour, for sure. This is a YouTube video. I will put it up on YouTube if I can. Soon it might be over anyway. Yeah, and nothing was created except through him, it says. What is excluded is also included, no? You have to see this one also. Not only when they use the word included, that means the rest is excluded, also in the contract, but also when you say except through him, there's the exception. This is very, very deceptive, that I might not even be able to see through. It says, and nothing was created. It's the first part. Then nothing was created. This is what you have to see. You really have to split the sentence. In German, we would make a comma inside. Maybe. I think now the new rule is also not making comma. A separation. And nothing was created. It says very clear. There's something coming after that puts then the sentence further and then changes the meaning, but it says nothing was created. Because that creation is really the nothing. I told you this before. It is nonsense. It has no senses, the words, in the world. And everything that is coming out of the words is the instruction, cut the trees, make a cottage, make do this and this, and then open field, do agriculture and whatever, you know what I mean? Instead of just let grow everything and, you know, plant the seeds of what you were eating so that you have more of this to eat and you have so much to eat you cannot even eat it because you have also animals that, also other life forms that want to eat, you know, full of abundance. It's all destroyed on the whole earth. And it will go further. Terminator is coming. Like in the Avatar movie. Remember when they came with their machines? Like this. And I don't think animals will be able to go against it, you know? This is just a fantasy. It will even be that the animals will be also injected and also turned into zombies, you know? Really dangerous. And programmed to eat you when you are still remaining, you know? Yeah, so nothing was created except through him. This is the inclusion. So to exclude the other thing, but if you see it together, only him, the word, remember it's the word, which is with the grand architect, yeah? with the occultist. Only through the word was now created, and this is true. Since then, more and more, you know, the creation recreates itself also. This is whatever. You can call it also kind of programming, but this is a live program which is undefined, not with ABC 123. It always recreates. But when you take off the life form and you cut the tree and so on, and you know, it will die. And then you have your house or whatever, you know, the block house, then, or the log cabin or whatever you call this, then, you know, you have only the dead things created. That is the nothing. The GA words forming the world. The grand architect's words forming the world. Thus, he is the soul responsible for the mess we are in now. Yeah, he started this, but you know, everybody who took this over, included me, is of course also responsible. So the soul responsible, no, you are the soul responsible. So this is the finger showing, you know, you Namboodiri, 1 hour. You Namboodiri, you know? Oh, wait until the beard is growing. Maybe you also look like a Namboodiri, you know? 3 fingers showing back. So, you are responsible for this. That's why this is coming now, yeah? And going against everybody. And then for the mess we are in now, is also, yeah, we are in this. Yeah, this is true. This is not just one. This is many. Many are into this now. Yeah. So, another four lines. The world gave life to everything that was created. I think it's written like this. Yeah. The world, God, this is unbelievable. The world gave life to everything that was created. It is kind of, yeah, because when you're in the fantasy, you ask people, is this real? The car and the house, they will say real. But it's actually dead. That means it's not real. Yeah? Because people understand something else of real. But as I said before, the word real means sun god. Is this of the sun god? The Saturn? Satan? Yes, that is true. So the world gave life to everything. Yeah, normally a thing cannot be alive because a living body is not a thing. This is what Marilyn Monroe already said. I'm not a thing. And especially not in nothing, in no thing, and also not everything or something or whatever thing. So this one, either I cannot understand this or, you know, the word gave life, but kind of, yeah, in the fantasy, the word gave life. That's why living Bible and so on, because you have the words in your head and this is all ruling over you. Actually, the word took over life. This is what you can say to everything that was created. So the car is driving, you know. If you don't have idea how this is working, it's just fantastic, you know, it's magic. And other things, and it's kind of, you know, when it's moving, oh, looks like alive, you know. The fictional world of a deluded man was empowered by his life force energy only. Fictional world of a deluded man was empowered. This is the power, the energy. This is the life energy. That's why it is very real. It looks very real. It looks like real. By his life force energy. Only, and therefore the motion started. The emotion. And his life, you see, life. There is also the lion side, because this is his life, you know, brought light to everyone, brought the false light, like the light, you know, the of the electricity in your home or the street light, to everyone. One is a dead number. So when I use the word everyone, I'm actually referring to the dead people. You know what I mean? And when I refer to somebody that I think is alive, has a soul, or has some consciousness, then I would prefer to say everybody or somebody, you know? Because then it refers more to the living body. So his word. So his fake life, his word, or GA, or God, fake life brings the intellectual illumination to everybody, human. So his fake life, the word, or the GA. Ah, word and GA means I'm referring to his. Yeah, he, him, his. His hissing also, yeah? His, you can hear it, the snake also. So his word, or, yeah, the fake life brings the intellectual illumination. You can see the intellectual and then illumination to everybody. It brings to everybody to form the everyone, to form the you man, the shade, the shadow, the color, the type of a man, not a real man, that thinks as one, civilized, social, robot, slave, drone, monster, zombie, you name it, as one, dead. Dead is actually also, you name it, I put the dead behind, because that's also important, you name it, dead. Okay. Yeah, the last long line. The light shines in the darkness, it says. Or the darkness has not understood it. You check out if it is written like this. If you have the Bible, you just compare. There are different versions anyway, but that is somehow correct. But that's what I, you know, I don't know anymore if I copied this from the internet, or maybe somebody put the comment up like this with these first words. You know what I mean? And then I just copied this out and into the notepad, and then I was doing my own thinking, and then give the answer. Because I felt like I know something about this, you know? I can see something. Yeah, the light shines in the darkness. Again, now they connect the word with God. The God, the word, become he, him, his, and then it becomes a light, because the word gave life to everything, and life is connected with light, truth. That's why you think you're speaking the truth, which is not the case. You cannot speak the truth, because it's actually not a light, it's an artificial light, or it is just the darkness, actually. It's a very strange thing that you can only understand when you know about black magic more, because you need this imagination. Just think about black light. When you check out, you know, your arm for the graphene moving from the skin into your tissue and whatever. Black light. It's called black light, no? That's what it is, black light. And it's also illuminating something. So the light shines in the darkness. Shines and shows the darkness, the graphene, you know? You can also say the moonlight shining in the darkness. Yeah, in the nighttime, you know? Or the darkness has not understood it, cannot stand under it. So that means the darkness is, of course, the human. Yeah? Just think about the cover picture of Pink Floyd, the prism and the light going through. That's what it actually symbolizes, because the prism is in the darkness also. So the darkness cannot understand it. That's why the Christians cannot understand what is written here. And even I cannot fully comprehend it, for sure. If you think you can comprehend, then you're already gone, you know, you cannot comprehend. You have to always assume that there's more. But I think what I wrote there 2 years ago was already quite good, because there's not many things that I would say different now. The sterile, my explanation, the sterile white light as contrast to the complete darkness, yin-yang duality. That's what I saw. The sterile light, this is, you know, the street lamp light, or now this LED light, white light program, as a contrast to the complete darkness. Yeah, you can see now the moon is getting also you know, becoming full moon, you can see this, huh? The corona around and so on. Yeah, it's interesting to see. This is the yin yang duality. Yin for female, ying is meaning female in Thai, and the yang actually, yang, the male. You can also feel like yin, the darkness compressed, and the yang, just by the sound of the vowel, you know. And when there would be a G behind ying, it would be even shorter, but it is yin, so it is a little bit longer. That light is identical with the moon. Ah, I saw this already, you see. That again stands for the illusion. See the Taoist symbol? And this is what I saw, because in 2019 I was in the park of Nakhon Sawan, the heavens town, and there they had whatever Buddhist Taoist Taoist temple with this yin yang symbol, very nice but extended. I never saw like this before. Actually took also the picture and put on the Facebook somehow. This was very good, this picture. No, not I took the picture, but the friend that I was showing this and explaining what this is, also regarding the flat earth model, because it's actually like the flat earth model from above. Yeah, that's why I put it in, because I had this picture in my head, you know. The light represents, the word represent is also very interesting, because you have re and pray and sent. So it's actually two prefix and one main word, actually. No real suffix. Sent is not the suffix, is the main word. Yeah? Sending is actually the past version of sent. And it's also sent, the center. Yeah. See it this way. Then pray is pre, also with an I, can be written like this, and the re. And re in Latin means back to again, yeah? But it is the re, the ra, you know, Egypt. And then the pre is also the pre, the pi ra, and then sent, as I said already, sent is sent, S-A-I-N-T, the center, the Satan. So it is Ra, priest, Ra, Satan. This is what represents this. But if you see the whole word, represent. Yeah? And then you cut off the first prefix, which is Re, you take it off, because you have also present. I present something. So either you represent something, that means you fake it, you are an imposter, or this is what the word means, and or you present something. But even the word present means pre-sent. That means it was sent before. In the beginning was the word. It was already. Yeah, it is pre-sent. This is a very confusing word also to get your head around there. So when the light represents, that's already an imposter. It's a false light. We heard about the false light. Yeah, the light represents the intellect of Lucifer. And I choose the word represent. No? I did not say, you know, I would not mean this light presents the intellect of Lucifer. No, it represents only. Yeah? So, intellect of Lucifer. Lucifer can be seen as the moon, can be seen as Saturn, can be seen as Venus, yeah? The morning star. And so, when it's already then I would also include Mercury and Mars and Jupiter, because this all works together. This is all Lucifer together. The many are one, all for one, and one for all. And the darkness stands for the humanity that does not comprehend what really is going on. the humanity, the human ET is in the darkness. Then I wrote myself, this was then enough, it goes further, but no need to explain the whole Bible, no? Would be endless. We can never extinguish it. I refer to it again, yeah? We. That's already a little wrong because you are not we. We is the cult. But that's what I was thinking. You can never stop this. But when it has started, it will stop. But it will only stop when humanity is wiped out. Because then there's no one to think anymore, you know? We can never extinguish it, the Luciferian force. So I see this as a Luciferian force, but I don't see the Lucifer thing as really something bad. It is just what it is, you know? Which seemed to be the case when we look at our helplessness regarding this problem with the alphabet thoughts spinning in our heads. Yeah. That's true. You cannot get this out. It's impossible. Yeah. Only as Arthur said, with the generations, you know. Mass exodus, which is already over, will not happen. You can see the vaccination. You cannot do this with vaccinated people. It's impossible. And, you know, she even said this. Yeah, then you are the one who's left behind, you know. You will have the new earth and we will all go, whatever. They are ready to go anyway. But I say this will not be the case. When the vaccine is activated, you will become the zombies. She said this also herself, you know, because I told her this before. And you will actually put this man on the cross or stone to death. And this is also how it is written in the John's Revelation, you know, the martyrs have to die. So I know already what will happen, you know. Yeah, and this, you know, if you think, oh my God, if this is real, then I better give up. Yeah, then you give up eternal life forever. This is the question. Of course, to die like this, you know, maybe also like Jesus, 3 days or something, you know, until all the life force energy is out of your body, is very terrible, for sure, because just 1 minute, I experience is already so terrible, you know. Yeah. Any deeper thoughts to it? It's only thoughts, which is farts, you know. So, just think about it. If this is something you can relate to. And then there's another part. I don't know if I put this up here. Maybe I should put it up. There's even the Facebook link. You check it out. This is good. I will put up the Facebook link and then you can see it. But this post will not be there anymore. Maybe you reposted it. So when I know Arthur was public open, I'm not sure. Maybe he's not even on there anymore. You have to check out yourself because I cannot do this. Now on my computer, it will block everything, and I'm not going to bother about this, but you can check it out. Here's the Facebook link and you can actually see the whole thing, but my must be off because I'm blocked there or deleted or whatever. You repost it. He would see this, you know. He would think, he's back again, you know. You can do this. Because remember, you should not delete anything or block somebody, you know, but everybody decides for himself. So we put this also, the PS, postus scriptum. This is after the writing. Because there was also something in this article which was very interesting, and I also performed this, and this is really working very well, you know. This proof of fact of where you really are right now is very deep thinking. You have to look at this article to see this and read this first. You know, this is really a study. Proof of fact. You have to bring the proof of fact, not just claim. Where you really are right now. This is the question. I will do this now with you. And you can check it out there also, and also the response to this, you know. Can you prove where you are right now? Can you, or can I prove where I am right now? Can I do this? You see, I'm sitting on the sofa. Maybe not. Maybe I use the software and I'm just the avatar, you know what I mean? Or maybe this is all just Matrix anyway. And this is all not real, and even the sofa is not real, but I have a special software, you can see, looks like real, you know, but it's actually just the software, you know. You have this already on the, I saw this at least with others, you know, on the iPhone or whatever. You have certain things in use already. So maybe it's all not real, you know. Also with the pictures I have seen on Instagram, I think, who's this guy, you know? Ah, this is the same guy, but he make himself look younger, whatever, you know. And this, of course, for the children, the adults, it is fun, you know. Yeah. It's very deep thinking, I said to him, you know. This is really good. Most of us can't grasp it. I will not use it on my street work, because at that time I was, you know, when people talked to me, then I was always referring to this. Otherwise, they might pick me up for the mental asylum. Uh-huh. But I actually did this. When I was in Thailand, you know, in the barber shop, and I had to wait, then I asked in Thai, can you prove where you are right now? And I did this also with another friend, a female friend, and she said, yeah, I can slap your face, and then you will know where I am right now. And I thought that's actually a good move, because this only works when you're online. And it is in reference to this is here all not real. You know what I mean? That's why I said this can all be faked anyway. So online you cannot prove where you are right now, because it is fake anyway. But she said in the reality I can prove you that I'm here. You know what I mean? I just have to do something physical. But without doing anything physical, and this is the problem, you cannot do this really here. You know? So I can say where I am, I can put in the link to the address, Google Street View and so on, and if possible, but now it's not possible anymore, you would come over here, you know, for the next holiday or something. But you cannot go, because you need to be vaccinated to enter this place. You cannot go anymore. Bye-bye. You know, and vaccinated people, I would also not be interested, really, you know. There's nothing, yeah, you have to really draw the separation line. Not in every case, it's not that you really put them off now, but, you know, there's no need for, yeah, staying together with these people, you know. Yeah, and then you would be able to see this. But everything that I'm presenting here, I'm here now, and so on, is just a claim, you know? This is no proof of fact. Yeah. So I was thinking about it, how he did this. Can you prove where you are right now? No, I'm here in my place. Can you prove it? And then people think about proving, you know, and then you actually realize, I don't really know what proving is, because how do I prove it now? Yeah, prove it now. Prove that you are here, the place that you claim to be. Can you prove it? You are thinking, you know? And you're thinking you're smart and, well, yeah, I'm sitting on the sofa. You see me moving. Yeah, is this real? Can you prove that this is real, what you are just presenting now? We already have the software with Adobe and whatever, you know? Adobe. Then, no. Cannot prove, no? You cannot prove where you are right now. In one time and said this also. No, cannot prove. Oh, I say, I'm very surprised, you know. And he was very proud. And the barber also said, yeah, cannot prove. But the one who was saved, he said, course, can prove. And then he was quiet. But nobody could, this I don't expect of these people, could explain why. So I explained then why, you know. But in reality, it's different. So they could have said, or the one who was saved, wait, when I come up, I prove you that I'm here, you know. Yeah. But he didn't think so far. But he was very, oh my God, what is this? You know? Oh my Buddha, he would say. I would have come to close as here and now in the question. You know, can you prove where you are right now? And I say, I'm in the here and now. This is the right answer to say, but I'm in the here and now. And I have nothing to prove to you. Also, you take it or leave it. That's the thing, you know what I mean? But I must stress the point that this here is all not real. When you watch it, this is anyway already in the past, doesn't exist. But that's what I can say. I would have come to close as here now. Yeah? Can you prove where you are right now? Is the question yes or no, actually. Can we prove or not? Yes or no? But you can see in the, if it's still there, that somebody who was not stupid tried to prove it. The question is not to prove it, can you prove it? This is the first thing. Yes, I can prove it, and then I prove it. Or no, I can't prove it. When you cannot prove where you are right now, you're gone. Because you are here now in the fantasy. The internet is a 666 fantasy. It's all not real. Okay? So, these are the words closest to the truth. Here and now. Because the here and now is the time and the space compressed into the moment. So it is closest to the truth, because the moment, in the moment, life is in the moment, truth is life. Yeah? But they ain't true at all. Yeah? The words are not true at all. As every word is a lie. Every word is a lie by its so-called nature, like natural law. It's only a law that is kind of according to the nature, but not natural. It's not the law of nature. Law of nature is something different. This is how really the nature works, and not to make up, you know, a law book according to what you find in nature. When you are undefined, then it is impossible to define, prove where you are, what you are, how you are, and who you are, etc. When you are undefined, you are undefined as a life form. Every life form is undefined. No grain of the sand is same as the other one. It's all different, unique and original. So it is impossible to define, prove where you are. I'm not sure if this is really correct, but because when something is alive, it is self-evident, so to speak, yeah? Self-proving. And actually, this could be kind of wrong, because referring to life, the words cannot prove, but when you are alive, then you are already self-evident, the proof that where you are and what you are, sensing what you are, and sensing how you are, and who you are. So I have to correct this in a certain way, because the words cannot tell you this, and the picture that you see here is also not telling you. It's not proof of fact, yeah? So when you're undefined, it is impossible to define, but the word proof would be already different. Because defining is not about proving anything, you know what I mean? It's just putting this with the definition. So this I have to correct, because that would be actually wrong, but I don't know how to change it now also. But when I correct this with the words, I think then it's already okay. It's already on the records. You see, there are certain things that because of words, yeah, it's always, in the end, it's everything wrong still, you know. Because here in this case, I try to present the truth, and this is only trying. You cannot do it with words. That's why it will be also faulty. So, with this method, you can bring the deluded man close to the gate of exit. Nonsense system matrix mental asylum. Yeah? Because it is something about to show that you are actually in a fantasy construct in the head. Yeah. And yeah, close to the exit, to the, yeah, they call it like this, you know, the gate, where the gatekeeper is, you know, leaving the nonsense, the system, the matrix, the mental asylum. But I said already above, you cannot leave this because you have the alphabet in your head. You can check out any time you want, but you can never leave for as long as your brain is working. And when the brain is not working anymore, you have to leave the body, because the brain cannot function the body anymore. If he only can follow you through. That means if he can understand what you're up to. And you can read it. Arthur is always just short, you know. Yeah, prove it. Yeah, I'm here on the sofa. Prove it. Yeah, I'm here in my place, you know. I'm just typing here. Yeah, prove it. Yeah, very much confused. You cannot prove it, because you are in the fiction, in the fantasy. You are using the tools of the fantasy, and there's no proof. This I also wrote, you know, in the one of the first comments down in the folder Words Magic on YouTube. I also wrote that you know, the problem about the fiction is you cannot prove or disprove anything. You know, it's just fictional. So you have to see that this here is all not reality. It's all fantasy. Most of us would give up and return to nonsense while there is nothing there. Yeah, and this is also what I experienced when I did this. Can you prove where you are right now? There was no answer. They cannot even answer. Which is probably the best, because also Arthur said, you are not answerable to anybody. You don't answer, but it should be also that you don't answer, but then understand, okay, yeah, actually cannot prove it. Fuck, I cannot prove where I am right now? That's strange, you know? You prove it through your senses, and that's why this woman said, I slap your face, and then you will feel something, right? Then you know I'm here. You can go further and can say, yeah, but I only felt your hand. But it doesn't mean that you are still here, because it can be also done in another way, whatever, with whatever technology, that you feel something like this, but it's actually also not real, you know what I mean? Included the ghost stories. So the answer must be no, I can't prove it to you. That's the correct answer, and most of the people would not be able to get to this point, because then it must make you realize something. As it's undefined, no words can tell. You only can prove it to yourself by using your senses. Right, that's correct. So, now we got this all. It's also long enough, this video. Again, the question is, can you prove where you are right now, here on the internet, especially? Because you see that this is all now going to the internet. We will do everything online, and you will be sucked in, and you will be also lost with this. And this question. Can you prove where you are right now? You will see. No, I cannot prove it. I'm lost in the fiction. So it's very important, this question, to make you realize this is all fiction, it's all fantasy, it's all not real, it does not exist, it is not alive, it is dead, dead world. And when you don't leave this world, the system matrix, the mental asylum, the nonsense, then you're gone forever. No way to return. So, should be enough. And everything that I say, I also refer to me, yeah? That's why. So, 136, and we don't wait until 36, because that's already enough. What I have to say, again, important. The reason for your life here on Earth is nothing else than to create your soul, your sun, your star, your light, your truth, your life, your existence, through care for life, live for life, by connecting with all other life forms, preferably plants, animals, and maybe if you find some man, but not the vaccinated human, because they are dead. They cannot give you anything. They can only suck your energy or kill you. This is what I see. So you will have very few possibility to do this, and also with the plants and animals it will become fewer and fewer. I mean, here I can find street cats still, and eventually also dogs. Plants is also a lot of plants still here, you know, as it is just growing, even though they destroy everything over and over again. But also this will be less, but it doesn't matter, because even here in the flat I have, you know, the whatever here, the, I call it the little crocodile, you know, the lizard on the wall, and of course the cat, and I have a few cockroaches, which doesn't bother me anymore. This is all no problem. I think I have even a rat down under there, because I have the corn powder that I use as a powder, because here it's hot, you know, you have to use powder. I powder myself with this, with the natural thing, and I heard some sound, and I see also one thing that is actually like a, you know, excrement from the rat. But also no problem, yeah? The rat is like a mouse, but it's always behind, because he has also the cat, and the cat cannot really go behind, you know, so it is safe behind there and can eat them, but probably nothing to drink. I don't know how the rat is doing this. Then I have a musang. It's also a big cat, but with a long tail. This is another kind of animal. But this is only coming in the nighttime and eating. I put the food outside, you know. And ants, I have some. Now not so much because of the wet floor. The floor is already dried. And yesterday I had to, you know, wipe off this room. If I didn't tell this already, I'm not sure. This was really hard work. But I managed that only the water came here to the beginning, not the whole floor. But I had to wipe 6-7 times, and I was very tired, and I was actually angry already. I was thinking, if they come now and want to, you know, want to get money for the rent or something, and claiming they are the owner and not taking care of this place, I would just fuck them off here. Fuck you all, you know. I was so angry about this. Anyway, it's like this. So what I mean is, there's always some life forms. If you dream for the life form will come, even just one end, and you just connect by looking at it. This is how you create your soul. And when you have your soul, you have your firepower. It's not about winning against these entities. It's just for your own, so to speak, yeah? And with this soul, so to speak, with this life force energy, you hang on life, you will be able to continue. And if you don't want, because there's also the deception of, you know, this all nonsense, this all matrix, the whole earth, then, which I also take serious, yeah, I look at this as well, but I see it different. I see it more the way Arthur looks at this. You have reality and the other thing is fantasy. You have to see the difference between earth and world. It's different. They like to put it together and even call it planet, planet ET. They like to call the earth also the world. In Thai, it is also just one word, but here in Malay, it's two words also. They make a difference. So when I speak in Thai, then I have to say the, you know, the world earth. I say then the word of the soil, you know, so that somebody knows I mean the real thing and not the fantasy thing. Yeah, so this should be it. Create your soul, grow, care for life, live for life, and then, yeah, hopefully you can make it.